Hello, friends. Today we'll learn about various inventions. Hey, buddy. It seems you enjoy riding a bicycle. You're able to ride the bicycle because of the invention of wheels. Invention of wheels. The earliest wheels were used as potter's wheels. They were invented in Mesopotamia, modern-day Iraq, about 5,500 years ago. They were actually used by potters to shape clay. Later, wheels were fitted to carts so that humans could move the objects easily. Some of the early wheels were solid discs of wood cut from tree trunks. Others were made from short wood planks, some rounded, some ovals, and others amorphous. Around 2000 BCE, someone came up with the bright idea of cutting out pieces of wood to make the wheel faster, easier, and lighter. Another clever idea came with the invention of an axle, a rod that passed through a hole in the center of the wheel. Turning the axle turned the entire wheel, saving both energy and time. This is the basic principle behind most of the mechanical devices, including this scooter and bike. Your bicycle runs on the same phenomenon. Wow! You've drawn the bicycle's wheel on this paper. Do you have any idea how paper was invented? Don't get confused, buddy. Invention of paper. Over 2000 BC, people in Egypt made something like paper from the papyrus plant. They cut off the skin from the stem of plant. Then they used to combine the thin slices all together. Plant extracts and some water was spread over this to make it stable and firm. Then they used to dry it in sunlight, and once completely dried, they were able to write on these. It was then learnt by the people of Greece and Rome. The credit for invention of paper goes to Kai Lun, a dignitary serving the Imperial Chinese court who began producing sheets of paper from scraps of old rags, fishing nets, and tree bark in AD 105. The Chinese kept the art of paper making a secret for many centuries until their invention was brought to Japan by a Buddhist monk, Dam Jing, in the 6th century. The Japanese learned this technique soon and began using pulp derived from mulberry bark to produce paper. They used to dry it in sunlight before using these thick sheets of paper. Then paper making began to spread to other European countries. With the expansion of mass circulation newspapers and the first best-selling novels, enormous quantities of cheap cellulose were created, and thus the industrial manufacture of paper began. You want to know who created the first paper manufacturing machine? Louis Nicholas Robert in 1797 created the first Fourdrinier machine, which could produce a single 60-centimeter long sheet. With the spread of cheap paper, literature was accessible to all. How did you draw the wheel on the paper? With a pencil? Right? Let's see how pencils were invented. Invention of pencils. It all began in 1564 when a large deposit of graphite was found in Borrowdale, England. At that time, people didn't know what the material was. It looked like coal, so they tried to burn it, but it didn't burn. Then they noticed that the raw material could leave its imprints, so they tried to write with it. But it was so soft that it started breaking quickly. Also, it left marks on hands. One curious mind came up with the idea of wrapping string around it. Later, someone else devised a wooden stick hollowed so they could place the graphite inside to protect it from breaking. Though the British discovered the graphite, it was the French who were responsible for creating the modern-day pencils. To be specific, it was Nicolas Jacques Conti of France in 1795 who actually built pencils. Oh wow, you're clicking a picture of these beautiful flowers with your mobile phone. So pretty. Show it to your friends. Invention of mobile phones. The first ever mobile phone call was made by Motorola employee Martin Cooper on April 3, 1973. He placed a call in New Jersey. The call was the foundation in the development of mobile technology, though it took another decade for the Dynatac to reach consumers, and next two decades for cell phones to overtake landlines in worldwide usage. But today, phone is synonymous with living, because almost every human definitely owns one. I'm sure all your friends have their own mobile phones too. Well, you deserve a treat after learning so much, and you look hungry too. Here you go, a chocolate bar for you. Invention of chocolates. Hoo-hoo! I love my Mexican hat. Chocolate's 4,000-year-old history began in ancient Mesoamerica, modern-day Mexico. The first cacao plants were found here. The Olmecs in Latin America were the first to turn the cacao plant into chocolate, though it was bitter in taste. Joseph Fry is credited for the modern-day chocolates. He discovered that he could make a moldable chocolate paste by adding melted cacao butter back into Dutch cocoa in 1847. By 1868, a budding company called Cadbury emerged, and it was marketing boxes of chocolate candies in England. Richard Cadbury came up with the idea to sell their fancy chocolates, known today as assortments, in decorative boxes, and this was a huge hit. Now Cadbury is one of the largest company making chocolates. It has evolved to be everyone's favorite. Ah, you're having chips here in the park. Let's see how it was invented. Invention of chips. You know the potato chip was invented by a chef, George Crumb, in 1853. He worked at the Moon Lake Lodge Resort in Saratoga Springs, New York, USA. Fries were popular at his restaurant, and once someone complained that the fries were too thick, so Crumb made fries that were too thin to eat with a fork, hoping to annoy the fussy customer. The customer, surprisingly enough, was very happy, and potato chips were invented. What an accidental discovery! These potato crunch were soon packaged and sold in New England. In 1895, William Tappendon manufactured and marketed the chips in Cleveland, Ohio. Later, a salesman, Herman Lay, involved in potato chip manufacturing with his eponymous brand of Lay's potato chips. In 1926, Laura Scudder invented a wax paper potato chip bag to keep the chips crunchy and fresh. This made potato chips even more popular. Hey buddy, look up. There's an aeroplane in the sky. As a general rule, the commercial planes can fly from 550 to 580 miles per hour. Let's see how aeroplanes came into existence. Invention of aeroplanes. The first ever successful airplane was built by the American Wright brothers in 1903. However, the idea originated from the flying birds like gliders around 400 BC, which was never documented to have achieved flight. Airplanes were demonstrated in World War I, and in 1919, Alcock and Brown were able to cross the Atlantic Ocean without any break or failure. The same year, the first commercial flight took place from US to Canada. Airplanes were there in almost all the battles of World War II, after which the first practical jet was the German Hinkel, P-178, launched in 1939. The Bell X was the first aircraft to exceed the speed of sound in October 1947. One of the earliest widely successful aircraft commercial service, Boeing 707, was in service from 1958 to 2010. The Airbus A380 surpassed it in 2005. Everyone loves ice cream. Do you know how ice creams were manufactured for the first time? Invention of ice creams. ice cream has been said to originate either from Persia or Rome. Some people say that it was Marco Polo who brought the culture of sorbets from China. Earlier, snow was used to make cold drinks, and then salt was added to lower the temperature. The kulfi, which is a traditional Indian dessert, is considered the first frozen dessert, and then a lot of flavors have been added by Europeans. Ice cream was accessible to people normally from the mid-18s, and the first ice cream stand opened in front of Charing Cross Station by Carlo Gatti in 1851. Then ice creams were transported to countries like Norway and Wellington. Agnes Marshall suggested the use of liquid nitrogen for freezing. Ice creams became inexpensive when cheap refrigeration became common. The very popular joint, Baskin-Robbins, made 31 flavors initially, and now it is said to sell over 1,000 flavors throughout the world. Now you know a lot about various inventions. Stay tuned for more videos. Bye-bye.